and old legacy, the oldest railway network in Asia, and something that resonates with images of the colonial era. We're talking about Mumbai's very own train network, the lifeline of the city, built in 1853. But 150 years since then, this is what it's become. Crowded and bursting at the seams, simply unable to cope up with the 6.6 million people who commute by it every day, because the network is pretty much the same. Very few lines have been added on, despite the rise in commuters and the fact that Mumbai alone gives 40% of all income earned by the railways.
This is the cash cow. The railways are minting money out of the suburban traffic, making profits out of it, and as long as the railways are running, no one is just bothered to do anything very drastic.
So what has been done and what more is needed? Well, in 1999, the government of Maharashtra and the Indian Railways came together to form the Mumbai Rail Vikas Corporation to improve Mumbai suburban trains with a World Bank loan of 1,613 crore rupees and a budget of 3,125 crores. This included more tracks, new trains, running of 12-car rakes on all lines and much more. But the result? Well, a four-year delay in just commencing the program and work that is not happening at the pace required. The project, which included a total of 6 lines, 550 new trains and much-needed facelift to our platforms, was to be completed by 2011 in two phases. But the work is still stuck in the first phase. And even the authorities were candid enough to admit that there is a long way to go.
We will be able to reduce the overcrowding. Already it has been reduced from 4,500 to 3,600 or so, a survey reveals. But still 3,600 is not good enough, because for each sitting there is 3 standing. 900 is sitting capacity, and so we cannot give a comfortable seat to anybody. So even if we are able to achieve a figure of 3,000 passengers in 9 car, we are happy.
But all these delays apart, there are bigger problems as well. For one, land is a problem, and encroachment by the track has meant that more of the money from the railway budget is being spent on rehabilitation of slum dwellers. And years of neglect has also meant that technology is obsolete, and it will take a while to make all these amends. The solution includes construction of 2 new lines between Kulla and Thana, optimization of the central western harbour lines, construction of an additional line on Western Railway, an increase in the number of coaches per train. That apart, refurbishing of the existing coaches as well as introduction of new rakes is something that is crying to be done. And while all this has been proposed, the devil really lies in implementation, which has been the problem. The need of the hour is to carry out the recommendations made nearly 10 years fast and quick. And new trains and new lines that are proposed to be introduced to ensure that this lifeline of the city takes care of the millions of new commuters who travel by it year after year. Clearly, efforts have been taken to improve the situation, but the Mumbai authorities have woken a little too late to the problem, and the consumer is facing the brunt of this. It'll be a while before their efforts actually transcend to the consumer. Till then, it's a daily commute to and from work. Rubina Jacob, UTVI, Mumbai.